boron trifluoride. So you know the central atom is boron. You take the three fluorines and distribute them around boron somehow. For the valence count, what column is boron in? Remember, keep using the AB designations on the columns. It's 3A. So three valence electrons for boron. Fluorine has seven valence electrons. There's three of them. Total of 24. Divide that by 2. We have 12 pair to distribute. Bond the surrounding fluorines to boron. There's three pair of electrons distributed. Then get an octet for each of the surrounding atoms. So we add three more pair to each of the fluorines. Four, eight, 12 pair, we're out. So there's no more pair of electrons to put onto boron. And the next rule says if the central atom has fewer than four pair, make multiple bonds to satisfy the octet rule. So that's what you would normally do at this stage. You would pick one of the fluorines and do a multiple bond and get the boron up from three pair of electrons to sharing four. Well, let's look at that from a formal charge point of view. So the structure on the left is where we ended. The structure on the right is what happens once you choose to double bond with one of the fluorines. Let's go through the formal charge. So start with the Lewis structure on the left. Boron has a formal charge of 0. All three of the fluorines are equivalent to each other, and they end up having a formal charge of 0. Boron trifluoride has an overall charge of 0. So you add up the formal charges, well, they're all 0. They add up to 0. Okay. Now we'll go after the structure on the right. I've done a subscript on one of the fluorines to distinguish that one from the other two, since that one has a double bond and the other two have single bonds. Boron has a formal charge of -1. Fluorine, the one on the left, has a formal charge of +1. And the other two fluorines have a formal charge of 0. All right, so they need to add up to 0 because boron trifluoride is neutral. -1, +1, 0. There we go, they add up to 0. So recall what you do when you're comparing formal charges. When you have multiple Lewis structures from which to pick, you pick the one that has more zeros. The Lewis structure on the left has more zeros. So if you're thinking, man, but that one has fewer than 8, yes, you have to know when to go fewer than 8, and you have to know when to go more than 8. The central atom for structures with fewer than 8 valence electrons will be those with a central atom of boron or beryllium. So the Lewis structure on the left is the better Lewis structure. That's the proper one.